फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू आवर डॉक्टर वेट चैनल। आई एम डॉक्टर पी आर पटेल, प्रोफेशन हेड वेटरनरी मेडिसिन। वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन पार्ट वन पार्ट टू ऑफ द एफीमेरल फीवर। टुडे वी विल सी लास्ट पार्ट टू कंक्लूड द एफीमेरल फीवर। इन दिस लास्ट पार्ट वी सी कॉम्प्लिकेशन ऑफ द डिजीजेस, लीजन्स, diagnosis, differential diagnosis, treatment, prevention and control of this important viral disease, ephemeral fever. Most of the animals after disease, there is spontaneous recovery, mostly 100% recovery, but very few animals show sometime complication after disease. If the disease is very severe and the proper care is not taken, then it may lead to a complication. Now we see here the complication. First complication is reduction in milk production. After completion of the disease or recovery from the disease, there is 100% regaining of the milk production. But in very few cases, there is a decrease in milk production and as low as 80% reduction is observed. Due to this viruses, the animal become more susceptible to mastitis. So if proper care is taken, proper antibiotic is given at the time of disease course, then chances of mastitis is very, very less. So clinician, remember, this is viral disease. This is not a bacterial disease. But if you give antibiotics, it can check the secondary bacterial infection and prevent diseases like mastitis. Aspiration pneumonia is one complication. If the disease is very severe, if the animal is sternal recumbency, and if there is lateral recumbency, there are all the chances that rumen material may enter into the respiratory tract and may lead to a complication of aspiration pneumonia. It is a dangerous condition. Due to effect on the muscle may remain weak for a long time post disease complication. And such animal remain unfit for the drop purposes. Remember these things. Pathological lesions. Most of the cases survive very nicely. So, chances of postmortem is very less because there is recovery. But the scientist has observed that there is enlargement and edema of lymph nodes, serofibrinous deposition that leads to inflammation of the synovial membrane called synovitis. There is inflammation of the tendon sheath where there is attachment to the muscle and other attachment to the bone. If this tendon sheath is inflamed, it is highly painful. So called tendovaginitis is observed on postmortem. And characteristic periarthritis. The joint and the tissue surrounding joints are swollen. In very few cases, pulmonary and pleural congestion is observed because the viruses are lodged into the lungs. Edema and hemorrhages of brain and meninges is also observed in some cases. But characteristic lesions observed are necrotic changes in the skeletal muscle, because this is a disease of mesodermal tissue. Virus affects mesodermal cells, skeletal muscles and lymph nodes. So these two characteristics are observed. One is the enlargement of the lymph node, and second, necrotic changes in the skeletal muscle are the characteristic findings. Diagnosis is very easy. There is no doubt about the diagnosis, because there are typical prominent symptoms are evident in cattle and buffaloes. One thing, on the first day, there is sharp high fever. Second day, characteristic shifting lameness. This is characteristic. The pain is shifting from one leg to other leg within few hours. That is characteristic. The course is very short and rapid, only for 3 days or at the most 4 days. And high morbidity and the least mortality. By these prominent symptoms, diagnosis is very easy. The samples to be collected are, and sample of choice are, blood, especially buffy coat and serum are sufficient for the diagnosis in the laboratory or for confirmation of the disease. From the clinical symptoms, it is confirmed that it is ephemeral fever. But for further confirmation, the laboratory tests are required. First is isolation of virus by intracerebral inoculation of mice or hamster, or isolation of virus in cell culture such as baby hamster kidney cell lines and monkey kidney cell lines. There are certain serological tests also helpful in confirmation of disease. Complement fixation test, agar gel immunodiffusion test, fluorescent antibody test, and ELISA test. On examination of blood and performing differential leukocyte count, neutrophilia is observed and marked leukocytosis is observed. Clinical pathology shows there is increased level of plasma fibrinogen. This is also a characteristic. And increased level of creatinine kinase or creatinine phosphokinase. Generally, the muscle cell contain creatinine phosphokinase. When there is damage, there is rupture of muscle, and this creatinine phosphokinase is present in the blood in high amount. So this is a characteristic. Increased level of creatinine kinase suggests the muscle damage. There is a decreased serum calcium level is also observed. And so, for the treatment also, we are giving intravenous calcium borogluconate because of the decreased serum calcium level observed. While discussing the clinical findings, we have also discussed that the disease shows the symptoms similar to laminitis and milk fever. But this disease can be differentiated from ephemeral fever by their characteristic symptom of ephemeral fever. The laminitis can be diagnosed by there is an inflammation of sensitive lamina. That is one. Laminitis is a local problem. Number two. And on palpation and percussion of the sole, the animal exhibit severe pain. This is the characteristic diagnostic point for the laminitis. Differentiation of milk fever. That milk fever, there is a history of recent calving. 99% of the cases of milk fever occur at about parturition. So this is one history. Second is characteristic three stages of the milk fever. Stage of excitement, stage of sternal recumbency, and stage of lateral recumbency. In ephemeral fever, there is sharp rise of high temperature. In milk fever, there is normal or subnormal temperature. And the milk fever cases give the complete classical response to intravenous calcium borogluconate therapy. By this way, we can differentiate laminitis and milk fever with ephemeral fever. Treatment. As this is a viral disease, there is no specific treatment. We have seen that the disease is of 3 days. So spontaneous recovery is observed after 3 days. Most cases recover. Very few cases become complicated. But treatment is helpful. Treatment enhances early recovery. In acute cases, there is severe pain. So treatment relieves pains and the treatment reduces the chances of complications. So by giving the treatment, there are 100% chances of recovery. There is no chances of complication. So treatment must be advised. Treatment is anti-inflammatory treatment, and phenylbutazone is highly effective, and NSAID, non-steroid anti-inflammatory drugs. They are anti-inflammatory, they are painkillers also, and they are antipyretic also. We continue the treatment in this presentation. Anti-inflammatory also contain antipyretic, but some of the chemicals have a antipyretic property. They can also be given. Complicated cases require antibiotics to check secondary bacterial infection, especially to prevent pneumonia and mastitis. This is very important. Other treatments are based on any additional symptoms. And if there is any complication, supportive treatment help, especially good nursing and care. In this presentation, we see prevention and control. Very important step is vector control. But this vector control is usually impractical. It is not practical in endemic areas because these flies are in groups and large in number. So it is difficult to control. Another step for control is vaccination. Vaccination is generally not performed, but if there are valuable cattle, valuable animals of high producing in endemic areas, vaccination should be done. Both formalin killed and attenuated vaccine can be tried in endemic areas, and they are giving good success. Remember here, cows aged more than 6 months are vaccinated. Cows below 6 months do not suffer from disease. Remember, cows below 6 months of age are not sufferers. So cows more than 6 months are vaccinated. Friends, with this we conclude a disease ephemeral fever. It is a very important disease. It is frequently occurring also. Share this information to veterinarians and veterinary friends, students. To promote the channel, request to subscribe this channel. Thank you very much for observing this video. Next time we'll come with such other videos.